A picture taken today by an eye reporter in Liberation Square. The sign held by the protester on the left says, "My father won't steal $70 billion from me," a reference to one of the highest estimates of Hosni Mubarak's personal fortune. It's impossible to say exactly how much money the Egyptian dictator has stashed away, but even the lowest estimates are in the tens of billions. Meantime, 20% of Egyptians live in poverty. According to the World Bank, the median annual income in Egypt is just $2,070. That's compared to $17,700 in Saudi Arabia, $46,360 in America. Tom Foreman's been looking into the Mubarak fortune. Tom, what have you found?
Well, Anderson, we know that a variety of news organizations, as you mentioned, have tossed around some very big numbers, putting Mr. Mubarak's personal fortune at somewhere between 40 and maybe 70, 75 billion. We also know that those numbers involve a lot of guesswork. Just look at that range, $35 billion. So these could be way, way off. Part of the trouble is also with this high-end estimate. It just doesn't fit in very well with what we know about other rich people in the world. For example, Forbes says the richest man in the world right now is this Mexican telecom owner whose wealth is estimated at almost $54 billion. So look at that, $54 billion versus $75 billion, $70 billion. This would make Mubarak the richest man in the world right now. That raises some eyebrows and makes people say maybe this isn't quite right. But look at another part of this. The Egyptian Constitution says the salary of the president shall be fixed by law. He may not receive any other salary or remunerations, may not exercise any free profession or undertake any commercial, financial, or industrial activity, and on it goes. Now, obviously, there are a lot of questions as to whether or not he pays attention to the Constitution, but even if this regime is corrupt, to amass such a huge fortune, you'd have to be talking about very long-time Constitution-bucking levels of corruption, which would be relatively hard to hide, Anderson.
It seems like we're frankly just don't know. I mean, what are the Mubaraks? They're not talking about this. He's obviously a very wealthy man. No one's disputing that, do they?
No, nobody's disputing that. It's plausible that he could indeed, as you said, have billions and billions of dollars. Much of the speculation on his supposed fortune swirls around his time in the military and the notion that he may have engineered massive profits for himself in military contracts and then played out those connections over the years. There's no proof of that. But even if it were proved, locating that money for some sort of national reclamation, if that's what people want, is fraught with problems. The Swiss could possibly reveal whether or not he had hidden assets in their country this week. We're waiting to see that. But that's just one place he could have stashed money. Think about all the tax and money havens around the world. We've been chasing rumors all day about property he or family members may own all over the globe. But one forensic accountant we spoke to said, look, there are rulers who were driven from power years ago, and authorities have yet to track down all of their secret wealth. Anderson?
Compared to the average Egyptian, he's obviously extraordinarily wealthy.
Yeah, that's really why this is such political dynamite. There are 80 million Egyptians, and as you mentioned, one out of every five lives on less than $2 a day. That has fueled the anger and had led to this revolt, and that could keep this hunt for Mubarak's money alive for many years, however much it is, and wherever it might be hidden. Anderson?
It's a frustrating thing trying to figure this out. I should point out a couple things. The bottom line is there is no transparency in the Mubarak regime, hasn't been for 30 years. So that's part of the problem in trying to track this down is there's no accounting. There's no public accounting. He's not accountable to anybody, even though there is this constitution. And even the Egyptian military, which is very mysterious, they own property. They own businesses. They generate huge sums of money in ways which aren't really clear to outsiders. So there's a lot of stuff going on inside the regime that, frankly, we can't.